these people are not dancing, but making a silk unique to China known as Xiangyunsha or tea silk. Few people have greater respect for this traditional Chinese technique than Kathrin von Rechenberg. Because of this rare material, she came to China from Munich, Germany 20 years ago and has never left since. For her, tea silk is something irreplaceable. This is Kathrin's first time at the Beijing Fashion Week and her first open fashion show in her 20 years in China. Although she has been preparing for many months, she still feels nervous. Tea silk is a unique Chinese silk with more than 500 years of history. It's also the world's only silk that is dyed solely with plant extract and has different colors on either side. It's very silky, metallic black on one side and shiny brown on the other. All of the fabric originates from Shunde, a district in Foshan, Guangdong province.
Und hab danach noch einige Jahre in Paris gearbeitet in verschiedenen haute couture ateliers. Ich war bei Dior, Christian Dior, bei Christian Lacroix, im Prêt-à-porter bei Chanel und auch während der haute couture Zeit in Paris mit fantastischen Seidenstoffen arbeiten konnte. Nie, also als ich damals vor nun sagen wir ja über 20 Jahren die Teeseide das erste Mal in den Händen hielt, war ich ja unglaublich fasziniert, wie
Kathrin 从小就生活在艺术氛围比较浓厚的一个家庭里面. Kathrin 的父亲是一个陶瓷艺术家.
为什么刚开始我第一次看见香云纱我这么喜欢它？因为我父亲在他的吊饰上面用的那个釉，特别香那个特别光的那个香云纱。
Kathrin first encountered tea silk in 2000. Her friend told her that it came from China, so she decided to leave Paris and head there. In China, she thought she could easily buy the fabric in markets, but hardly anyone in Beijing even knew what it was. That was also when she met her future husband, who took her to different cloth markets on his bike in search of the fabric. This is her tea silk collection. Because it's a handmade fabric, flaws are almost inevitable. A perfect piece of tea silk is a rarity. The Beijing Fashion Week is approaching, and time is getting tight. Between 30 and 40 outfits need to be exhibited at the show, but Kathrin still doesn't have enough tea silk. She decides to go to Guangdong and meet her business partner, Zhou Xiaogang, to see if he has some perfect tea silk. She also wants to talk with the textile workers to see if she can find new inspiration.
那个砖没有那个销量。有的，但是为什么一面光？那它晒了就会有一面光。是，刚刚做好，是。啊，刚刚做好，做好，做好。那我可以选吗？现在这个可以。要。
可以要，我到时候我拍一个照片给你。
什么？
现在你现在这个很难挑，我到时候叫他们每个发型拍了照片，我发给你。
啊，我不能现在挑。
因为这个不是我挑好了一个干性的吗？是啊，那你等一下吧，等一下吧。 我跟凯瑟琳已经合作了很多年了，我们凯瑟琳就属于一个比较痴迷中国传统那个染整技艺的一些布料的人。我要这个光子，还是这个？我还是不要那么光，这个有。不是，你在单子上面，你给我们的单子上面写一下。
对他们觉得好玩，一个外国人他说那个香薰茶这样那样，就要这样做那样做，什么都不懂，他都还老说。他作为一个服装设计师，他必须要了解这个布料的生产，因为这个特殊布料，比较传统的特殊布料。如果他不认识这个制作工艺，他是没办法去利用同埋裁剪呢啲咁嘅布料。
Only staff are allowed into this workshop for making tea silk, but Kathrin can come here to visit Mr. Lu. Of all the people she knows, Lu is the most familiar with silk. He is in charge of the production, research, and development of tea silk. It takes remarkable persistence to do this job. Mr. Lu makes all the tea silk that Kathrin uses. These gray pieces of yarn all have colorful names, such as Victory, Swastika, and Cloud. They form the foundation for perfect tea silk.
That's my dream. I never thought that one day I could come to this cotton量的那个，能采收量的那个地方。
The dying yam grows in mountains, valleys, and forests in most parts of southern China. The tuber is rich in tannin, the major dyeing material for tea silk. The plant is common in China, but the wild ones in Guangdong are the most suitable for dyeing. Kathrin has come to gather some yams and bring them back to Beijing.
Xiangyunsha is 100%天然的染法，因为那个数量。
特别重要，在这里边是一个大磷酸，大磷酸的那个染料，他们都不用一个固色漆。对，这颜色很漂亮，但是还是不够深吧？哈哈，这是第一颗，现在不错哈，挺大吧。
Kathrin wants to dye some silk herself for the Beijing Fashion Week, but she isn't satisfied with the color. Mr. Liang is the most senior worker at Zhou Xiaogang's factory, so she decides to consult him.
不知道你们这次染20遍还是多少遍这个面料最少？第一刚刚开始的时候是那个染料没有那么浓，然后它越染越需要再加一个更浓的一个那个染料。
就希望你揸，即系主要系不缺磷水，系嘛？即系冇缺磷水，点样为之叫磷砂呢？咁啊，他闻出来，他摸出来，他尝出来，你在哪里工作一个星期能学习会了？这个不可能的。
我又做咗几十年啦，系嘛？即系靠你自己眼光鉴定啲嘢，O 唔 OK？ 解封水系要轻，即系淡定啲，第二处、第三处啲要高，即系要浓一啲。好啦，戴到第五处啦，开始又是慢慢又是淡，开始一步一步你淡落去嘅，唔可以急进。
很不可思议，这么能一个面料染30多遍，反正每次还需要筛，等它那个干了以后再染30多遍。
要有嗰个太阳，有嗰个温度先做啲裤先系靓噶，你冇话住啊？
晒凉嗰啲草地咧，但系咁样，即系如果嘅水泥地就晒唔到嘅，就系草坯地咧就晒得到嘅。草坯咧佢有个地气啊，紫外线晒落去，抽佢个地气上嚟，然后个底咪变白色咯，个面咪变红色咯。见太阳嗰边同喺草坯个底嗰边系分啊个鸳鸯色嘅，始终都系。
It's not Kathrin's first time seeing tea silk being dyed and sun-dried, but it leaves her deeply impressed every time. Just like people, natural dyeing goes through the four seasons of the year and is sensitive to the changes in wind, rain, sunshine, and sand. It's very different from the lifeless chemical dyeing process. Tea silk is more or less unique to Guangdong because of its ideal climate, local water quality, and the silt of the Pearl River. These all combine to give tea silk its unparalleled quality. The connection between the Pearl River and tea silk was established 500 years ago. Tea silk is produced only in Guangdong because only the local river, mud, and people can rejuvenate it.
即係啲泥啊，掃喺北部上面掃到均勻嘅，即係佢咁俾佢厚啊，薄啊，薄咧就係飲得啊嘛，薄咧就係佢個北部咁夠黑嗰度，黑到咁夠，有啲紅紅影出嚟咧。
哦。
Xiangyunsha is 完全天然的面料，那个染发是完全天然，只是那个泥巴是从河里边挖出来，然后去掉也是再放在河里面。 特别辛苦呢，肯定年轻人可能不怎么愿意做一个这么辛苦的一个工作，因为是最热的时候、最晒的时候，他们在晒这个面料，然后锅泥巴也是夜里的时候，所以这个都是很辛苦的一个工作。
It's a magical process, a perfect coordination between nature and humans. Plant, silt, temperature, time, grass, sunshine, humidity, and wind work in harmony. The textile workers may not be experts in physics or chemistry, but they are masters in the science of making tea silk.
服装秀的时间越来越紧了，凯瑟琳的压力呢就越来越大。她看的任何事情都不满意，看着什么都不对。我也是做了十几年了，我也是个老裁缝，待到这里好像就一些从零开始，一样那种感觉。刚开始我真的有点崩溃的，我第一个月做的时候真的也特别不习惯，就是对我的技术要求特别严格，而且凯瑟琳对于她真的是一丝不苟，她对工作特别认真。就她也就没有说是没有差不多那一说，就必须得好。
凯瑟琳挑料子比较认真，一点也不能马虎，一点也不能说凑合，不像那有的那个说的，哎，大概齐差不多，他没有大概齐，反正都一直他都选的都完美吧。我觉得我在那个艺术上还是工作上，越来越像我的父亲。
我爸爸是，可惜他现在已经去世了，就是多年前。
特别要求非常高的一个人，他不会表扬什么别的艺术家还是设计师，还是他的眼里面没有什么好东西。<笑>我爸爸他一直用陶子，别人可能会觉得这个没有很大的变化，因为一直是一个材质，然后那个颜色也不会很多，对他来说是够嘛。
那我也是这样子的，祥云纱对于我来说也够。我觉得，在这个范围里面，我可以自己有好多的那个变化，就不用好多那个颜色。觉得他的就属于那种反设计的设计风格，就是有自己的设计理念在里面，不会去跟风。但是他喜欢就是尽量剪裁少一些，保留面料原有的那种状态。 我觉得就是在这么短的时间之内，然后把这些衣服全都做好，然后做完美，还是在时间上面有一些压力。
Tea silk becomes denser during dyeing, which hinders the embroidering process. Common needles can't be used for this silk. So Kathrin buys a special fine needle from France. has changed her life.
Before I came to China, but I couldn't imagine what to expect from the tea silk because I had never touched it, I had never seen it. It was like a unique texture that I didn't know from any other fabric. And of course with silk, you always expect something very, very soft and flowing. And this was totally new to me.
在它的一个很小的一块布里边，你能感到很多层次的颜色的层次。你看它的时候，我觉得你就非常想摸一下，就想知道一下，哎，什么感觉？我觉得它搅了一个很好的一个那个把两个国家或者两个文化结合的那么一个方式。For
Kathrin, every dress is a work of art. It has to be functional, not just decorative. Kathrin believes that when people put on clothes made with tea silk, because of the unique way it's made, they can feel the value of the silk, not just the clothing. It's also a way of paying homage to this traditional technique.